Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap 4 video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, this video is another extract from one of our courses, How to Build a Coming Soon Page with Bootstrap 4 from scratch. We're going to demonstrate how to use Google Fonts with your Bootstrap 4 site in this video. Google Fonts are absolutely awesome. If you're looking for some interesting fonts that are slightly different from the default ones that you can use, go to Google Fonts, and we'll show you in this video how to incorporate them into your website. Once again, this is an extract from one of our courses. You can get the full course from a discount link below. We're giving a huge discount with this for our YouTube subscribers. It's just $10 or $9.99, so take a look. Let's get started. In this video, we're going to explore Google Fonts and how to add Google Fonts to our Bootstrap 4 website. This is what we've got at the moment. It's the default Bootstrap font going on here. And we perhaps want to make this more interesting by adding a stylized font for the headers and perhaps another font for the body text or the paragraph text here. So let's go to Google and just put in Google Fonts. There we go. Click on the Google Fonts and it'll bring up the Google Fonts page. And all these are free to use. You just want to put them in your site. And if you have something in mind, great. If you don't, you can just scroll through the lot. You can select serif fonts, sans serif fonts, display, handwriting. I'll just demonstrate. Let's uncheck all of these. So now you've just got serif fonts. And our serif means it's got those little tags underneath and on the side there. If you just want sans serif fonts, no tags, clean looking. Personally, I actually prefer these. But there's no account for taste, so you want to get what you want. Display fonts, there's something with a bit more wow factor to them. I mean, you've got some crazy stuff here. Handwriting fonts, they're quite fun. Script fonts that look just like handwriting. And there really are some great ones here. Some people have taken a lot of time designing these. And monospace fonts, which are real simple fonts. Like these. And you may say, well, that's all well and good, but how do I put them in my website? It's pretty easy, actually. Let's have a think what we want to do first. Here's our page. Let's do something with our title here. So we want something with a bit of impact. Could use the impact font, but that's not what I'm looking at. Let's use one of these display fonts, perhaps. Alpha Slab 1, that's pretty interesting. Okay, well, let's use this monotone. I'm not going to use these. I'm just going to show you how to use them, but let's use this so we can see for effect. So I'm going to hit the plus button to select this font. And that little black bar appears down the bottom there. Now, what we've got going on here is we've got a link with the style sheet for this font. And then we've actually got the font family for our CSS, which is great. So what we need to do, let's copy this link at the top from that opening tag to the closing tag. Make sure you don't clip off any of those. Control C to copy. Let's open our brackets text editor. And if we go up to the top, here's our style sheets right here. And I want to add this one just below our last one. Here's our custom style sheet. Let's give it a title, which is tag exclamation two dashes, and call it Google Fonts. Just makes it easier for anybody that's following along with us that will have to edit this template and find this easier if we give it a title. And drop down, and let's just paste in Control V what we copied from the Google site there. And this is going to pull in that style sheet for that font from the Google site. Let's save that, Control S. Now that we're doing that, we want to tell our site what we want to do it to. So if we go to our custom CSS here, well, let's back it up. All right, index HTML, we want to work on that H1 tag, which was that heading tag. This here, this is the one I want to affect with that new font. So we simply go to our custom CSS. It's an H1 tag, so all we have to do is write H1. Open and close some curly brackets, just like with any other font. And then if we go to our Google site, we can type this in, but they've kindly put it there for us. We just have to copy this. Control C, back to the site. Control V to paste, and it's pasted it in there. H1, font family, monotone, cursive. Quick save, Control S, back to the site. Now, when we refresh, that should change to that interesting font style there. There we go. And like with any other font, you can make it larger or smaller. Let's make it slightly larger. I don't know what it is at the moment, but just now I use 55 pixels and that seemed to work. Don't know if that will make it taller or not, larger or not. Control S to save. There we go, that's made it larger. But you get the idea. You can pull in any font from Google any way you want. And you don't have to just stop at using one. You can use more than one. We'll do the same thing. Let's find a different type. Let's try a handwriting script. And this is purely to demonstrate. That's kind of nice. This is purely to demonstrate what you can actually do. Well, that tangerines, I quite like that. Let's hit the plus on there. And it's added again to this little black bar down here. I'll get rid of that monotone because we've already got that. Here's the tangerine. And again, here's that link they've given us to the styling sheet for that particular font to make it look like it does. Control C to copy back to our brackets. We just simply have to plop this underneath the one we've got there. So there we go, there's the monotone, there's the tangerine. Save it, Control S. Now we've got to tell it what we want it to use this on. So let's go to our custom CSS. This time, if we go to the site again, let's use it on this, which is our paragraph text. See here, paragraph P. We could say on the lead, just on the lead text, because it's a class of lead, but we'll call it paragraph. So again, all we have to do, bit of space there, P, open and close some curly brackets, drop down, and let's just copy what they've given us from the Google site there. And Control V to paste. There it is. Control S to save, back to the site. Now when we refresh, this should change that nice cursive tangerine script that we just got from Google. There it is. A little bit small, can hardly read that. Let's make it a little bit bigger. Do exactly what we did with this. In fact, I'm going to copy that. Control C. Let's make it 25. Well, let's make it 18 pixels. See if that makes it big enough for us. Control S to save. And refresh. Made no difference at all. Let's inspect it. Okay, that's why. Because it's that lead class. Let's take that off. Let's take it up to just selecting it, and with my mouse wheel, I'm rolling it up. There we go. That's a bit more of a readable size. That's 41 pixels. So let's just remember that. Well, 40 pixels actually. Of course, when I refresh, it'll go back down to where it was, because that's non-destructive editing. And let's put 40 pixels here. Save that. And just for a second, I'm going to take that lead class away because it's overriding what I want there. We could put important in there, but I don't really want to do that. So if I take that away, it's just a regular P. Save that. Control S back to the site. Now when I refresh, that should. There we go. And of course, like any other font, you can make it bolder if you want to, or lighter if you need to. And change the color. So let's say light blue, I guess. Light blue should make a difference. Semicolon, Control S, back to the site. There we go. So that's how easy it is to customize your Bootstrap 4 site with a bit of Google fonts, should you get the desire to make it sort of stand out and interesting. And there's some wonderful fonts out there, there really are, so do take a look. For my purposes, I'm gonna leave it as it is. I want mine pretty straight looking, so I'm gonna go back in there, just gonna delete all of this, Control S, and I'm gonna put that lead class back in there. And I can do that by just going Control Z or Control Z to undo, as long as I haven't closed my brackets out and reopened it. Control S to save that. Back to the site. There we go. I've still got those fonts pulled in on the index because I've got the CSS link in there. So I can use them again if I want to. Just one other thing, we've covered this before with regular fonts, but you can also do it with the Google fonts. If you want everything on your site, all the text on your site to be a particular font, whether it be a WebSafe font or a Google font, really easy to do. Let's just get that tangerine again. I'm gonna copy that again. Let's go back to my custom CSS. Now remember, I've already got the style for that tangerine right in my index.html. So let's say we want this for the whole site. Instead of saying H1 or P or H2, 3, 4, blah, 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 put it in the body tag here. If you don't have a body tag, just type body, open and close. There it is. Now everything, H1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, P, whatever, is going to all be that tangerine. So if I save that, Control S, back to the site, and refresh, everything should change to that cursive tangerine. Bootstrap, H1, P tags, and also our links will down here. There you go. And that is not what I want at all, but it's just a demonstration of what you can do if you want to set the styles for your whole site. So let's go back and just undo that. So that is how to add Google fonts to your Bootstrap 4 website, should you get the urge. Well, there you have it. I hope that was useful to you. If you enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. If you're interested in web development, this course and many other courses you will find below. We've got some huge discounts for all our YouTube subscribers. There's also some great free courses down there, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.